Hello and welcome back to the next step in our Ice Shader tutorial series. In the last episode, we showed you how to iterate a simple parallax shader and use a custom function node in the shader graph. In this episode, we will show you how to randomize the parallax output and create more variation in the cracks inside the ice. First, we need another noise texture. In this case, we can reuse the one we used earlier in our tutorials to create bubbles or clouds under the ice surface. Feel free to experiment with other noises to generate different effects. Next, we create new parameters for our shader, noise scale and noise depth. This will allow us to control the influence of the noise texture. It's time to revisit our code function. As a small adjustment, we multiply our parallax offset by 0.01 and subtract it instead of adding the value. Since the values tend to be very small and negative, this makes adjustments in the editor much easier. Now we add the new texture and noise control variables, noise scale and noise depth, as input to our shader. We also have to use parallax offset for the noise, since we want it to be measured exactly where the cracks are. Noise scale acts as a tiling offset for the noise. Now we multiply the parallax result with the noise strength. We can use the material editor to fine-tune our values. In this example, we use a parallax offset of 0.2, 16 iterations, a noise scale of 16, and a noise depth of 2.5. As you can see, you can now get more variations among the cracked ice lines. Feel free to experiment with the material values until the result suits your needs. As a nice visual addition, we are now going to add some fake see-through transparency. First, we set our PBR material to transparent and leave the alpha values at 1 to get an opaque material. Next, we add two screen position nodes, screen position in default mode and screen position in raw mode. For the raw screen position, we use a split node to isolate the alpha channel. Then, subtracting a new parameter called ice depth from it. As the name suggests, this will be used to simulate the thickness of the ice layer. For the default screen position, we sample the scene depth in linear values and multiply it by the camera far plane value. These two values get subtracted and the result is fed into a 1-minus node. For the next step, the value is clamped and fed into our output emission control. And this is our first visual result. To get a better control, we add color. Multiplying it with the scene color and multiplying both to an adjustable brightness value. The result is then multiplied with the depth values from the previous step. To get some refractions into our material, we use the high definition render pipeline. First, you need a scene representing the surface under the ice. Here we use a terrain on top of our rocks from earlier. In our scene graph, we create a new lit master node. Set its surface type to transparent, the refraction model to sphere, and check receive SSR is on. Now for the alpha channel, we use the non-inverted smoothness map we created earlier and add 0.7 to it. Feel free to experiment with other values. For the refraction index, we just use a simple noise node. Set a very high scale, 1024 in this case, and bias its value by multiplying it with 0.05 to get variations on a really small scale, and adding 1, which is the initial index of refraction value. Next, we connect the depth color to the refraction color input. As an additional effect, we can use the false transparency as emission. You can adjust the setting by altering color and setting the false transparency's brightness until you are satisfied with the result. This concludes the tutorial. Using the color and parameters for the fake transparency and the refraction, we can see what's hidden under the eyes. Thank you for watching, and as always, if you liked it, feel free to subscribe to our channel and leave us a comment.